But for people that are listening and kind of wondering, we're talking about one of the major dietary regulators of the IGF-1 pathway, which maybe you can mention a little bit about the role of IGF-1 in the aging process.
Yeah, so proteins, and particularly certain amino acids, methionine, cysteine, et cetera, they regulate IGF-1 levels. And in IGF-1, in simple organisms, at least the orthologs of IGF-1, as well as in mammals, seem to have a important role in aging. It's not clear how much is IGF-1 versus insulin versus growth hormone receptor-dependent signaling, which is independent of IGF-1 and insulin. Most likely, it is growth hormone receptor. Growth hormone and growth hormone receptor, they are the sort of master controllers, and IGF-1 seems to be one of the axes that regulates or accelerates aging in multiple cell types.
Mm-hmm. And from humans, there's some evidence with polymorphisms and various like growth hormone.
Yeah, that's actually our work with not polymorphism but mutations in the growth hormone receptor, something called an E180 mutation. And the people, well, we knew from mice, from the work of John Kapchick and Andre Barkey, that mice that have either growth hormone receptor or growth hormone deficiency live longer, about 40% longer. They also live much healthier. That's probably, you know, I think one of the most important observations made in the aging field, that you know, you can live 40% longer, and yet about half of the mice get to the end of life without any obvious pathological lesions, so they don't develop diseases. And the controls, this is less than 10%. So, I'm pointing this out. Well, it's a huge effect, yeah. Right there. I'm pointing this out because obviously people think that if we extend the lifespan of human lifespan, then it's going to come with a lot of more problems, and instead, in the mice, but also in our work in humans, where we've been following these people with growth hormone receptor deficiency down in Ecuador, they're called they have a syndrome called Laronne syndrome, and so they're very much the equivalent to the mice, and they don't have a very long lifespan. They may live a few years more than their relatives. They don't have homozygote growth hormone receptor deficiency, but they're protected from cancer, they're protected from diabetes, and a recent paper showed that they seem to be protected from age-dependent cognitive decline. And all of these are matched by the mouse work.